sweeter harbinger of spring. As the winter gave way to the warm summer sun, Dwight Evans showed the way. And it wasn't the midnight ride of Paul Revere. The ride for the Red Sox had begun. And there was Mr. Consistency, that brilliant night when he wrote his name in gold letters in the Red Sox history book and in the history book of Major League Baseball. There was another great individual of many, and he came up with his blow against the team the Red Sox figured to meet in the fall. First place, the 15th of May. The ride had just begun. But there were injuries, there were bills to be paid, and Nipper and Hurst were called upon to pay them. But the ride continued, and the veteran hands of Tom Seaver came aboard. And then there was trouble, a low spot. The bubble had burst, and whatever other label you want to put on it, it was a temper tantrum. But back to Mr. Consistency. Once more, the Red Sox were in good hands. The calm, cool, and capable hands of Roger Clemens, and all was well by the end of August. And summer has gone, and fall is here, and the Toronto Heroics has slowed up the ride, but only for another day or two. It is inevitable. The Red Sox are on their last few strides to the American League Eastern Division flag.
Boston Red Sox. The game of the week is brought to you by Miller High Life.
Breaking ball down, and he went after it. So Fernandez opens up with a strikeout.
Out of it now.
Yep. Hitting 255, and it didn't help him. So Bruce Hurst starts out with two strikeouts, although I must say,
made by Cooper,
and he lifts it to center field, and there his arm is to catch it at the knees. No runs, one hit. They leave Gruber at second, and we're locked up scoreless as we go to the bottom of the fifth. Now back, and there's one backhanded by Fernandez. The throw got him.
Incredible, simply incredible how he came up with the ball. He got into just flipped the submarine and able to get Baylor.
Watch it. Look how far he is. Look at this throw. Couldn't get anything on it. The accuracy is incredible.
And Upshaw, like a pair of scissors, opened up, and Baylor trying to slide his way to break the perfect game. Two down in the fifth inning after a fine play by Barfield and Wright, a super play by Tony Fernandez. And here is Dwight Evans.
Kind of a play you used to see only an Ozzie Smith make, and here's a kid Fernandez making, and the way they talk about him, like he's been making them all year and hitting.
Well, you see two plays back to back like that, and you begin to start looking at the zero. Evans struck out in the second inning. Ball one. One, one. Go! Probably the best game Evans had with the bat 6 years ago. He had a five-hit game against Toronto. That's a long time ago. 3-1. High drive into deep left field. She is away out and gone. 2 and Toronto nothing. 358. That is just about capacity, maybe 200 shy. And they are here now to see if Bruce Hurst can get his fourth shutout, if he can beat Toronto, and more importantly, give the Red Sox the mathematical tie. A pop fly to Buckner on the right side. One away. Today, the Toronto Blue Jays. Ground ball to shortstop. Spike Owen, and they are one out away from the tie.
And these fans are primed.
Hold on to your hat, John McNamara. The fun is just beginning. And look at this crowd. On its feet. Hello, Boston. Everybody up. And here is Jesse Barfield. Strike. Away from clinching the tie. Strike two to Barfield. And two strikes to the leading home run hitter, Jesse Barfield. Pop foul off to the right and out of play. Bruce Hurst trying to shut out the team that has scored the most runs in the American League.